numbers. In this lecture, we are going to start with the important word problems from this lesson. That is, we will start with the second exercise. The first question says, a businessman earns a profit of 2,34,561 in the month of January. Rupees 1,95,467 in the month of February and Rupees 3,44,560 in the month of March. How many profit did he earn in this month? Okay. So as you know, it is word problem, and for word problems it is important to write the statements. Okay. So we will start with the statements. That is, we will start with all the given things. Profit earned in January will be with rupees 2,34,561. Profit earned in February will be this rupees 1,95,467, and then the profit earned in March will be equals to rupees 3,44,560. Now we have to calculate the profit only these 3 months, so it will be equals to the addition of these 3 profits. So it will be 2,34,561 plus 1,95,467 plus 3,44,560. Addition of all these profits will give you 8, 18, 15, 14, then 17, and then you have so. Therefore, total profit earned is equals to rupees 7,74,588. Okay. The next question says, there was a stock of 2,75,67,890 sacks of wheat in a godown of Food Corporation of India, that is FCI. The FCI sent 96,73,500 sacks of wheat to Odisha and Assam respectively. What is the remaining stock left with FCI? So FCI had total this many stocks. He gave this much stock to Odisha and this much stock to Assam. So what will be the remaining stock left with Odisha? So what will be the remaining stock left with FCM? So you will add these two numbers and then you will subtract it with this to get the final answer. Okay. Now let's write the given part first. Total stock, it will be 2,75,67,890 stock sent to Odisha will be this, that is 87,89,045 stock sent to Assam will be this value, 96,73,500. So the total stock remaining with HCI will be therefore remaining stock equals to, we will first add these two numbers and then subtract the final answer of this with this. Okay, so adding these two numbers give you 87,89,045 plus 96,73,500. It gives you 5,4,5,2,6,4 and 1. That is, you get 1,84,62,545. Okay. Now we will subtract this value with the given total stock. Okay. So you get 2,75,67,890 subtracted by 1,84,62,545. Okay. So you get 0 minus 5 will be 5, then you get 4,3,5,0,1 and then you get here 9. So that is total remaining stock left with SCI will be 91,05,345. The next question is, a merchant had ₹88,592 with her. She purchased 40 video games at ₹1,200 each. So the cost of one video game was 1,200 and total she purchased 40 video games. Okay. How much money was left with her after the purchase? So total amount she had in the beginning was this much. She purchased 40 video games of 1,200 each. So first we will calculate the total amount she spent on buying the video game and then we will subtract that amount with the total amount she had. Okay. So let's start. Total money she had equals to ₹88,592. Then the cost of one video game is ₹1,200 and she took 40 video games. So multiplying this number by 40 will give you the cost of 40 video games. Therefore the cost of 40 video games will be 1,200 multiplied by 40. Okay. So 12 fours are 48. So ₹48. 12 fours are 48 and 1, 2, 3 zeros. Okay. So 1, 2, 3. So therefore the cost of total video games which she purchased will be 48,000. Now she had 88,592 with her in the beginning. So after purchasing the video game, amount left with her. So therefore money left with her will be what? This amount minus this. So 88,592 minus 48,000. Okay. So it will give you what? Rupees. This will be as it is. Okay. If you don't understand, you can multiply it in the side and take. 48,000. Okay. So it will give you what? 295 as it is, then 0 and 4. So 40,592. 40,000. So The next question says a student multiplied 8355 by 89 instead of 98. So we had to multiply the given number by 98, but instead of that, by mistakenly he multiplied it by 89. By how much was his answer less than the actual answer? So we will multiply this number by this what the student had calculated, and then we will multiply this number by this to find the actual number. Then we will subtract both the answers to get how much numbers less he calculated. Okay. So, solution. Actual answer will be what? This number 8355 multiplied by 98. So, we will multiply it here in the side. 8355 multiplied by 98 gives you 85 is 40, then carry 4. 85 is 40 plus 4 is 44. Then again 483 is 24 plus 4 will be 28. 8 is 64. 66. Then 0, 9 5 is 45, 9 5 is 45 plus 4 49, 9 3 is 27 plus 4 will give you 31, so 3, 9 8 is 72 plus 3 will give you 75, so the answer by after adding will be 9, then 7, 8, 11, 8. So it is 8,18,790. Okay. So this will be your actual answer. 8,18,790. Okay. The answer calculated by student answer. Calculated by the student is 8355 multiplied by 98. Okay, so we will multiply this number again here. 8355 multiplied by 89. Okay, so we will take this number. 9 5 is 45, so 5 9 1 5 7, 0, then we have 0 4 8 6 and 6. So after adding, what you get? 5 9 5, then 3 4 and 7. So you get 7,43,595. Okay. So the answer calculated by the student is 7,43,595. Now we have to find the by how much was his answer less than the actual answer. So therefore, answer calculated by the student was less than the actual answer by subtracting these two numbers. 8,18,790 minus 7,43,595. Okay, so the answer will be 5, then you have 9, then one, then five, then you have seven. Okay. So the answer is less by 75,195. This will be your final answer. That is, you can conclude that by 75,195, his answer was less than the actual answer. The next question is, to stretch a trouser 1 meter 30 centimeter cloth is needed. Out of 15 meter cloth, how many trousers can be stretched and how many cloth will remain? So total cloth we have is 15 meters, and to stretch 1 cloth, 1 meter 30 centimeter cloth is needed. So how many trousers total we can stretch from this 15 meter? Okay, so cloth needed to stitch a trouser is 1 meter 30 centimeter, and as you know, 1 meter, since 1 meter equals to 100 centimeter, so we can convert this meter into centimeter. So you will get 100 centimeter plus 30 centimeter, that is 130 centimeter is needed to stitch 1 cloth, and total cloth we have is 15 meters. So that is 15 meters means how many centimeter? 1500 centimeter. Now to find how many number of trousers can be stitched, we will divide the total cloth we have by the cloth needed to stitch 1 trouser. Okay. So, number of trousers that can be stitched equals to 1500 divided by 130. Okay, I will divide the values here. 1500 divided by 130. Okay, so by looking here, 130 gives you remainder as 200. Then again 130 will give you 70 as the remainder. So total 11 cloths can be stretched and 70 centimeter cloth will remain. Okay, so the number of trousers that can be stretched is 11, as the quotient is 11 and the remainder is 70. And how much cloth will remain? So therefore, cloth that will equals to 70 centimeter. The next question is, a large tanker of capacity 15 kiloliter 500 liter is full of petrol. How many petrol pumps, each with a capacity of 720 liters of petrol, can be supplied with this tanker? So there is a huge tanker of 15 kiloliters 500 liter capacity, okay, which is full of petrol. So it is asked, how many petrol pumps of the capacity 720 liters can it fill? That is, if you have a very big tanker and you have to fill small petrol pumps, okay. So how many total petrol pumps will it supply the petrol? Okay, so for getting the number of petrol pumps which it can supply the petrol, we have to divide this number, that is, we have to divide the capacity of tanker with the capacity of each petrol pumps to get the number. So first we will write the given part. capacity of the tanker is what? 15 kiloliters, 500 liters. Okay. And as you know, 1 kiloliter equals to 1000 liters. So, 1500 kiloliters will be 15,000 plus 500. So that is 15,500 liters of petrol are there in the huge tanker. And now we will see the capacity of one petrol pump. It's given as 720 liters. Okay. So now we will calculate the number of petrol pumps which it can supply. Therefore, number of petrol pumps that can be supplied equals to this value divided by this. So that is 15,500 divided by 720. I am doing the calculation here. 15,500 divided by 720. So first we will see this number as it is 3 digit number. Okay. And here if you consider 3 digit number, then it is smaller than this. So you will consider 4 digit number here. So we will take 2s up. 720 2s up is what? 0, 4 and 14. So after subtracting it, we get 0, 1, 1, 0, then this number carried down. Okay. Now 720 2s up will be greater than this number. So we will take 721 up. So it will be 0 2 7 0 8 3. So this much liter of petrol will be remaining. So the number of petrol pumps that can be supplied is equals to 21. So therefore total 21 petrol pumps can be supplied with this tanker, and 380 liters of petrol will be remaining in the tanker after supplying 21 petrol pumps. Okay, with this we finish with another exercise. In the next lecture we will start with the fourth exercise, in which we will be studying about how to estimate the numbers. Till then, keep practicing the sums, and I will see you in the next.